Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's WTF What the Funk Music News. I'm your news correspondent, Shanny Marie, and in our C1 chopper cam, Less is More, and for our quickie recipe moment, Bianca Baker. Let's jump right into the top stories. In Cyndi Lauper news, Cyndi Lauper announces Girls Just Wanna Have Fun farewell tour. We will keep you posted on tour dates as we love Cyndi Lauper here on What the Funk Music News. Now in Eminem news. Eminem drops new single Houdini on May 31st. It hit number one on iTunes and Spotify almost immediately. The rapper is known for his sharp lyrics and has some pushback from the new release. Eminem was slammed for lyrics about Megan Thee Stallion's traumatic shooting and new song. Houdini is the first taste of Eminem's next album coming, The Death of Slim Shady. In other news, LA Guns announces Cleopatra Records for new album. That's awesome, as we love LA Guns and we will definitely keep you posted. Jelly Roll and Ashley McBride announced to host CMA Fest in 2024. That's going to be awesome. Now in Dolly Parton news, Dolly Parton revealed she did not know that Beyonce was rewriting Jolene, as she shared her thoughts on Beyonce's new album, Cowboy Carter. But she was quoted, she loves the album, and she was featured on it. In Young Gravy news, Young Gravy teases new song with Shania Twain called White Claw. This ought to be interesting, and we'll definitely keep our eyes and ears out for more news. Now, Jack in the Box partners with actor, rapper Ice Cube to introduce the new Munchie Meal. That's awesome. High five, Ice Cube. Now in Travis Scott news. Travis Scott earns highest grossing rap tour of 2024. Congratulations, Travis Scott. His tour is called Circus Maximus. It happens to be in an area near you. Definitely go check him out. Now in Sean Diddy Combs news. The rapper mogul can't keep himself out of the news these days. How will the house of Sean Diddy Combs cards fall? Well, it's happening right in front of us. With more allegations coming to light, we will keep our eyes on further allegations and evidence coming forward on the rapper. Now in DOJ Ticketmaster news. Will the concert ticket giant be broken up into smaller pieces? It's yet to be seen, but according to the Department of Justice, they've got a good case against them. The monopoly is over. Now in other Ticketmaster Live Nation news, there's been a breach. That's right, they've been hacked. Credit card information was found on the dark web. So folks, please make sure that you have checked your statements and make sure that you're not one of the affected customers of Live Nation Ticketmaster's hack. It's Pride Month. Elton John announces anti-discrimination Pride Month campaign. And now it's time for a quickie recipe with Bianca Baker. Bianca?
Hello, everybody. My name is Bianca Baker, and thank you so much for tuning in to my quickie recipe moment. Today's quickie recipe is going to be a cucumber salad sandwich. The total time on this is going to take you 15 minutes over here, and it's going to give you 2 servings. Now, you can have your choice of bread, or you can do a lettuce wrap if you're a little bit healthier or maybe on a diet, okay? You're going to need 1 cup chopped cucumber, okay? 1/2 teaspoon salt. 2 tablespoons of plain yogurt. You don't have to get fancy, but I do myself prefer Greek yogurt over here. 2 tablespoons of crumbled feta. And folks. I know that each one of you have your own taste out there when it comes to your herbs, okay? You can put 1 tablespoon, okay, of rather dill, parsley, mint, or for some of you out there, probably cannabis. That would work as well. Then what you're going to do over here is you're going to take a 1/2 teaspoon of lemon juice. And it does not have to be a fresh lemon. It can be the plastic lemon in the bottle. And then 1/2 cup of alpha sprouts. Don't get the weak ones. Alpha sprouts. And then 2 slices of red onion to go on the top of your sandwich. Okay. Now, for those of you out there who like pepper, put a little pepper on there to taste. Okay. And I'm telling you, this sandwich is not only really super good, but it is really good for you and it is very quick. And that is going to do it for my moment, my quickie recipe. And my name is Bianca Baker, and I will have a new amazing recipe for your palate next week. Back to the newsroom.
Thank you, Bianca Baker, for your quickie recipe moment. And now on to Rihanna news. Rihanna sets new record for diamond singles, title for the female artist. Go Rihanna, we love you here at WTF What the Funk Music News. Now in Bon Jovi news. Bon Jovi just surpasses over 1 billion streams on Spotify with his song, You Give Love a Bad Name. Not surprising, as that's always been one of my favorites. Bon Jovi drops new album, Forever. This will be the 16th studio album. Don't forget to check out the Hulu series called Thank You and Goodnight. The Bon Jovi story is now streaming. Country Music Hall of Fame spotlights Black country artists with an expanded version of the Black experience in country music. Now it's time for our Artist Spotlight of the Week. This week we're featuring Swamp Dog, Jerry Williams Jr., an 81-year-old R&B singer, songwriter, country artist, best known for his sleazy, wisecracking alter ego, Swamp Dog. His new album, Blackgrass, From West Virginia to 125th Street, Williams' 26th studio album as Swamp Dog, continues a renaissance that began in 2018 when he teamed up with producer Ryan Olson for the acclaimed Love Loss and Auto-Tune. Gone are the vocal effects so cheekily displayed on that last album, I Need a Job So I Can Buy More Auto-Tune, replaced here with the banjo, fiddle, and more raw, earthy brand of the storytelling. Swamp Dog had long dreamed for making an album like this one. He said ever since he was a kid in Portsmouth, Virginia in the 1940s, he was infatuated with country and bluegrass music, which he often heard played on Norfolk radio station WLOW, or some of the earlier records that his grandfather played for him. The first song that he learned to play was Red Foley's version of Peace in the Valley. Swamp Dog stated that his album is a mix of rhythm and blues, and don't forget bluegrass. He always wanted to put together an album like this. The new album does help with the extensive back catalog. Swamp Dog has written 2,000 songs, recorded or produced, including reinterpretations of songs he originally wrote for artists like the Commodores and the Drifters. There are also cover songs he loved as a child, like I Gotta Have My Baby Back by Floyd Tillman, or Have a Good Time, a pop hit for Tony Bennett in 1952. Swamp Dog stated, if it was a hit at one time, I don't care how long ago, it can be a hit again. Swamp Dog has hit the country scene before. Though he never received the credit that was due, most notably, he co-wrote She's All I Got, which reached number 2 on the country charts with Johnny Paycheck in 1972. But as a Black artist, he was caught between two worlds. When he attended that year's Country Music Association Awards in Nashville, he was initially mistaken for a member of the kitchen staff. Swamp Dog stated, calling the new album Blackgrass was a conscientious attempt to reclaim bluegrass heritage and reframe its importance to Black listeners. And to listeners all around the world. Swamp Dog recently had a film documentary, Swamp Dog Gets His Pool Painted, which premiered at South Bay by Southwest in March. Swamp Dog stated that Blackgrass is just the beginning of a new phase of music for him. He wanted to do a straight country album. This is me getting my foot back in the door. Jerry Williams Jr., also known as Swamp Dog, thank you so much for your amazing music and for being our spotlight of the week. Sending it back to the newsroom. And now here's my segment, In the Juice. In Van Halen news, Michael Anthony weighs in on Alex Van Halen's decision to quit music. He continues to grieve over it. Michael Anthony was surprised by Alex Van Halen's gear auction. It appears to be he's selling it. And now in Taylor Swift news, Taylor Swift calls fans champions for dancing in the rain at her French show. It was said at the same concert, Taylor Swift blushes while singing 15 at Lion Era's tour stop. Dating the boy on the football team will do that for you. Taylor Swift dominates the charts at number one again with little competition on the way. Congratulations, Taylor Swift. And now in Billie Eilish news. New documentary on Apple TV, The World's a Little Blurry, which was filmed in 2018 into 2020, where perhaps every second of her life has been recorded in some form or another. The director, Cutler, of the September issue, producer of The War Room, and executive producer of ABC's Nashville, has been immediately drawn to the project. Those stories of teenage life are very interesting to me. It's such a fascinating time where you were both a child and an adult, one foot in childhood and the other foot in adulthood. Billie Eilish was excited about the prospect of the documentary from the beginning. We'll keep you posted here at WTF What the Funk Music News when the docuseries drops. Now I'm sending it over to C1 Chopper Cam with Les Ismore. Les?
This is Les Ismore, reporting from the Chopper, C1 Chopper for WTF News, flying overhead of the Ticketmaster Live Nation headquarters. And it seems that there are 560 million people who had their data breached by a recent hack of the illustrious Ticketmaster Live Nation infrastructure, digital infrastructure. So there's 560 million people in the streets right now overhead. That's, if you don't know, folks, that's a lot of fucking people. I appreciate for the wobbliness here on C1 Chopper due to budget constraints with WTF News. I'm not only flying the chopper, hopping out of the pilot's chair, and then reporting on the side of the chopper. So every time there's a bit of a wind gust, I get a little bumpy here, like now. But I'm reporting the news as I see it, and holy shit, Ticketmaster Live Nation is really fucked right now. They fucked their customers, their consumers, for a long time. Now people are really pissed. The Department of Justice now has a lawsuit against them. Finally, the Department of Justice is doing something for the people, and it's good to see. But Ticketmaster Live Nation, I think we are witnessing the downfall of the great empire of the ticket fuck you universe and all the fees that entail. Jeez, another wind gust here. Let me get back in the pilot chair. Let me go to my next destination. I am overhead here. We just went by Tommy Lee's house. The drummer Motley Crue, his dick is so big, you can see it from a chopper. Moving right along, and we're going to go over here to, what is this, Hollywood? And looking at all the people on Hollywood Boulevard, where the stars are, the Hollywood stars, the people dress up website. There's a lot of whiskey being poured at the Whiskey Go-Go. It's a great venue, historic venue. You all must go see it. And that's it for me before I crash this chapter, because we almost had an accident last time, and the head of WTF News got her panties in a bunch when I mentioned that the chopper almost went down because we don't have it in the budget to replace it, which makes me think that we're not paying the insurance on this thing, which is another big concern because I don't know what's going to happen if I die in this thing. Anyway, back to whoever at the news desk at WTF News. This is Les Ismore reporting the latest news in rock and roll.
Thank you so much, Les Ismore, for your special report on our C1 Chopper Cam. Now, let's get into festivals this weekend. If you happen to be in the Chicago area, the Chicago Blues Festival is going on Sunday. Don't forget to check it out. I'm sure it's going to be delicious. On June 8th, the Governor's Ball 2024. Definitely check that out. New York City, baby, yeah. Infrasound Music Festival 2024 in Ellendale, Minnesota, June 6th through the 9th. Go out there and have a blast. Mountains of Music 2024 in Vail, Colorado. Boy, do they have a lineup, and that's also going this weekend. CMA Music Festival, Nashville, Tennessee. You can still get your tickets online. It's going to be a hoot of a party. Carolina Country Music Festival in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Tickets are still available online. And don't forget to check out GridLife Midwest 2024 in South Haven, Michigan. And that's going to conclude it for this segment of festivals this weekend. Now let's jump right into this week's top three music docuseries. And that's right, we've got a killer lineup. Coming in at number one is Bon Jovi, the Hulu series, Thank You and Good Night. It's streaming now and you won't want to miss it. Coming in at number two, TMZ presents The Downfall of Diddy. Definitely check it out on all major streaming platforms or whoever you subscribe to. Number three is called The Greatest Night in Pop on Netflix. On January 1985, music's biggest stars gather to record We Are the World. The team goes behind the scenes, and this is some of the shared footage. Definitely give this documentary a try. And that's going to conclude it for this week's WTF What the Funk Music News. Thanks for tuning in. Have a rockin' week, and we'll see you all soon. Bye, everyone.